Good afternoon and welcome to Chamber TV. Today marks the first stop of our summer tour, and we're netcasting from the new Frederick Visitor Center on East Street. So sit back and enjoy the show. Here are your hosts, John Michael Bailey and Jessica Hibbard.
Everybody to episode 7. John Bailey's back this month to help us kick off the summer tour at the new Frederick Visitor Center. We're going to be talking a little bit more about the Visitor Center and Tourism Frederick later on in the episode.
Welcome everyone. I'm going to just go ahead and say that the tour stops here because this place is fantastic and I want to do all the recordings from here on out.
Well, we'll see about that. If you're watching online, you've already found our YouTube channel. You can also connect with us on Facebook. Just search for Frederick Chamber TV. And you can join the conversation on Twitter by using the Chamber TV hashtag.
All right, let's move into Positively Frederick. This is the Chamber's community blog. Anyone could submit a story about something good that happened in Frederick County.
All right, well, this month's featured story is about something that I think we'll all be pretty excited about. Unless you're living under a rock, you've probably heard the news. Wegmans new Frederick store is open. And many of us have had great experiences there already. Bess Scalacci wrote about her love for all things Wegmans. You can read the post she submitted on the Positively Frederick blog. It's at positivelyfrederick.org.
They have Chevetti's sauce and bison dip. These are very important things.
I'm a little more basic. I'm kind of addicted to the muffins and iced coffee in the morning now.
They're all far as divine. We'd love to hear about companies that are doing things right in our community. If you've attended a fun event, if you've had great customer experience, service experience, or had positive interactions even with just your neighbors, submit your story online at positivelyfrederick.org.
Question of the month?
Let's talk about the question of the month, shall we?
Shall we?
Each episode, we have a new question of the month. In May, we asked you to help us choose some locations for our summer tour.
Obviously. Obviously, the Frederick Visitor Center got your votes. And thank you to everyone who participated in that poll. We're here at the Visitor Center today. Next month, we're going to be visiting the Frederick County Public Library's downtown branch, so that should be pretty fun.
See Burr Arts. Mm-hmm. We have a new poll this month. Since we're talking about tourism today, tell us your favorite local place to visit with out-of-town guests. Assuming you have friends from out-of-town.
Or, you know, if that's not the case, then if you staycation or if you just like to sightsee around town, let us know your favorite spots. We didn't want to limit you, so this is a fill-in-the-blank question, and we're going to share the most creative insider tips on next month's episode. The poll is online at frederickchamber.tv.
All right, now we move on to a segment called Mission Central. Leadership Frederick County's 23rd class just graduated on June 1st. I was there. It was a fantastic ceremony, a great speaker, a great event overall. Great graduating class. This chamber program is currently screening applicants for next year's class, so we thought we'd talk about LFC's impact on the business community today.
Yeah, we've invited Alan Mullendor. He's a commercial banker with BB&T and LFC's representative on the chamber board to talk with us today. Welcome, Alan. Yay! Come on in, scooch in a little bit closer. We want to be friends here, all right?
In the interest of full disclosure, I have served with Alan on the LFC Council, so I'm just putting that out there. But you're a Leadership Frederick County alum. Why did you decide to participate in the program, and what impact has it had on you as a business person?
Well, my decision to participate in the program really was just a general knowledge point for me. I wanted to get more knowledge of Frederick County so I could be a better resource to my clients and the folks that I touch on a day-to-day basis. And going through the program and staying involved with it and seeing it evolve has really broadened my horizons, opened me up to a lot of people that I haven't had a chance to get in front of before, and made some real tight bonds as far as not only business contacts but friends now. So I have a large group to reach out to and able to contact at any point in time.
Great. Well, LFC, for those who don't know, is a 9-month program. And the monthly field trips are extremely popular. Participants learn about local and state government, arts and entertainment, history, public safety, health and human services, the list goes on and on. But there's also an opportunity for some hands-on learning through the Leaders on Loan projects. So wondering if you could tell us a little bit more about this aspect.
The Leaders on Loan project is a wonderful opportunity, not only for the class to go through, but for the county itself to benefit and the local nonprofits. It's an opportunity for the nonprofits to work with a highly skilled group of professionals in the community to actually put something together. Could be a feasibility study, SWOT analysis, or things like that, at no cost to the nonprofit, but it also gives the class the opportunity to understand how nonprofits work and how all nonprofits are different and they have little quirks to them. So it gives them a chance to explore both sides, and also the county ends up getting the benefit of the project because both the class has got more knowledge of the nonprofit system, and the nonprofit now has a viable product in hand to actually better their organization.
So they're learning new things about the county during the day, and then they get to apply those lessons in real life.
Absolutely.
Pretty awesome.
Plus, I would say that they get to use their real-world experience and bring that to the table with these nonprofits.
It is. It's a chance for them to grow and actually change. Some people want to step outside looking at a project and do something different than they do in their day-to-day course of business. So it's a great opportunity.
It's a great resource to tap into. Well, thanks, Alan.
Absolutely.
LFC is really an awesome program. Interviews for next year's class have already started. So if you're interested, apply now. You can learn more at leadershipfredericktcounty.org.
Awesome. Thank you, Alan. We're not rolling today, I guess.
Sort of rolling. Scooting. Chamber factoids. Each month we try to supply a different chamber factoid that you can use to impress your friends at cocktail parties and networking events.
Truly impress them. Yes. Well, did you know over 700 community leaders have graduated from Leadership Frederick County since 1989? I think the exact figure is 734 alumni. So that's a pretty awesome group of people. And as Alan mentioned, you know, they're helping nonprofits, government, businesses all over the county. You can see all of their names in the Frederick News Post on Tuesday, June 21st. We've designed a very splashy ad for the newspaper with a complete list of alumni, so look for that in the paper.
That's 734 friends that Alan did not have before. Let's talk about the member-to-member spotlight. Everyone likes to save money, right? Right?
Right.
Right.
Yes.
Always.
Right.
We have a couple of member-to-member coupons to spotlight this month.
All right, that's right. All in a Day's Work is a new chamber member, and this virtual assistant business is offering 10% off your first job. So, if you need a little help this summer, maybe catching up after a vacation or reducing your hours to take care of kids who are out of school, this might be a great option.
Yeah, I'm thinking about it.
Yeah. Hey, I need virtual assistant. The virtual assistants I can get.
I need a virtual brain sometimes. If you're staycationing or if you're entertaining out-of-town guests like we discussed, you can consider a visit to the National Museum of Civil War Medicine. I toured it during Leadership Frederick County. It was awesome. They have a great buy one admission, get one admission free coupon.
Very cool. Well, you can find these discounts and many more on our website. Visit frederickchamber.org and click on the red button that says member to member coupons.
Front burner. We are putting tourism on the front burner this month and have a special guest from here where we are, the Frederick Visitor Center.
Yes. Becky Bickerton is the sales manager here at the Tourism Council, and she's joining us today. Welcome, Becky. Hello.
Come
welcome.
On in. We'll talk.
Well, I guess we don't say welcome. I mean, you're here all the time. So I guess I should say thank you for having
us.
Yeah,
thank you for having me. As we've mentioned already, we're here at the Visitor Center. This place is awesome. It's on East Street in downtown Frederick. For those who haven't been here yet, what are you waiting for? What types of resources and activities can visitors expect to find at this new location?
Well, we're sitting in one, this beautiful theater, which runs a continuous film during the day called A Turn of a Wheel, mm-hmm. The Wheel. and it explores all of Frederick County. So come and enjoy the film. We also have our exhibits out front and lots of brochures for folks to pick up visitor information, maps, guides. There's a lot about local history out there, so something for everyone to enjoy.
Yeah, I was noticing the exhibits the other day. We had our business card exchange here, and you know, whether you're into architecture, history, the outdoors, the arts, I mean, there's a lot of cool stuff to see in Frederick, and those exhibits spotlight it really well. Well, school's out. Summer's officially here when school's over. Traffic is light, so it's delightful. Many of us will be enjoying staycations or hosting out-of-town visitors over the next couple months, so tell us a few of the most popular attractions we could add to our to-do list.
Historic downtown Frederick. Come to historic downtown Frederick. We have shops, restaurants, art, architecture, museums. There's really something for everyone to do and to see in downtown Frederick. It's a very walkable and friendly place to visit. The great outdoors. We've got great parks in Frederick County. We've got hiking, biking, canoeing. Everything that you would ever want to do in the outdoors, you can do in Frederick County as well. So we've got the city and the outdoors as well. So.
Yeah. When people visit us, you know, we always have them walk along Carroll Creek, and, you know, everyone always remarks about what a lovely downtown it is, but it's also refreshing to just, like, drive 5 minutes out of town and you're in the countryside. It's pretty special.
I shower every morning in the mountains. It's very refreshing.
With the animals?
With the animals.
With the critters.
It's fantastic. Question, what is tourism's impact on our local economy? Can you share some facts, figures, numbers with us?
Well, just to give you an idea, in 2009, $367 million was spent here by visitors. Wow. Most of those visitors come from within a 50-mile radius. Mm-hmm. So they're coming from Pennsylvania, Ohio, West Virginia, New Jersey. They're coming from the area, and about 1.7 million visitors came in that same year as well to Frederick County.
Wow.
And they leave behind their tax dollars, which helps the local community as well. So
we like that.
Thank you, visitors.
Yes, thank you.
We appreciate it. Well, many business owners don't deal directly with visitors and tourists. So, you know, they may mistakenly, I'm sure, think that tourism isn't impacting their bottom line. So what do you think you could tell those business owners to make them care about tourism?
Well, they may not feel they're impacting tourists directly, but they may be indirectly by dealing with businesses that do impact tourism. So food vendors, they're supplying our restaurants that visitors are eating in, they're still impacting tourism. So everyone is really touched in some way, whether directly or indirectly, by the visitors that come to our area.
Yeah, that totally makes sense.
I can relate. Thanks, Becky, and thank you to
the
yes, come to the Frederick Visitor Center, please, 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 and thank you to the Tourism Council for hosting today's episode, and all of the remaining episodes are going to be here. Way. This place is awesome, but yes, thank you for hosting today's episode of the Frederick Visitor Center.
Thank you.
There really are a lot of cool places to visit in Frederick County. So don't forget to share your favorite local spots in this month's poll. Maybe you have a really lovely shower location with like extra raccoons and squirrels that John would like or something. You know,
it's quite pleasant.
A little swimming hole with critters.
It's either there or I go hang out in Jess's backyard. Question of the month.
Yeah. You want to access that poll online. You can find links to all the topics that we've discussed today on Chamber TV on our website. It's frederickchamber.tv. All right, well, this episode has gone by so quickly.
It certainly has.
I guess time flies when you're having fun at the Visitor Center. Well, a lucky member of our studio audience will win today's Chamber TV prize. It's a signed copy of Hermanisms, an inspiring book about business, money, and life, provided by Q103 Radio. We're also throwing in a free ticket to our September lunch exchange.
Thanks for tuning in to our 7th episode, still going strong, made possible by the following donors and volunteers.
Randy Gray is our announcer.
The fabulous Kelly Beach is our producer.
Prize packs for our live studio audience were provided by Liberty Mutual, Specialized Engineering, Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, Giant Eagle, Aspire Women's Clothing Boutique, Roy Rogers, and Wood Street.
Snacks for our studio audience, and they are tasty snacks, were provided by Morningside Inn.
And of course, special thanks to the Tourism Council for hosting this month's episode.
Thank you to everyone who's here. Thank you for tuning in, and enjoy the rest of your summer. Until next time.
Until next time. Yes, join us in the live studio audience when we record our next episode, Friday, July 15th at 1 o'clock. Next stop on our summer tour is the Sieber Arts Library in downtown Frederick. Between now and then, we'll see you around town and online at frederickchamber.tv.